Well, Parish Councilman Joey Mayeaux has been around his district. We're at the Emergency Operations Center here in Amite, where he just came out of a big meeting. But you've looked around, and boy, the Wardline Road area suffered some of the worst damage, not just from wind, but from flooding as well.
From flooding, yeah. Tangi Village, typical. You know, it went underwater about 5 feet, and it just came up. Once it started coming up, there was nothing they could do. They had to go in there and get a high water truck and rescue a lot of them out of there, which was sad, you know, to see that. I tried to give them heed warning to get out, but where did they go? You know, that's the thing. You tell them that you got to get out, but they got to have somewhere to go. And if they don't, they're pretty much trapped, you know.
So tell us, where does this water come from? Is it from the Natalbany, the Little Natalbany, or?
The Little Natalbany, Big Natalbany. It came from everywhere. Look, I watched rain going up, not just down. It was sideways up, right? We've had, I don't even know what the numbers are, but I imagine we had close to 20 inches of rain. I'm just guessing at it.
So how about conditions now as far as your district, that is Baptist and the area, say, northwest of Hammond? How does it look?
It's devastated. It's devastated. We have roads open, the main roads. You know, single lane, majority of them. But it looks like a bomb went off. It's pretty bad.
So what are you hearing as far as recovery is concerned? I mean, obviously power, it'll take weeks for a lot of people, but who knows? I mean, energy always sort of lowballs the estimate so they can come in ahead of schedule.
Yeah, we're going to be optimistic, and we're looking at weeks. You know, I would recommend anybody right now that can go to a family member out of town, go there, because you're going to be 3 weeks. And if you think you can realistically run a generator, home generator, for 3 weeks, buying fuel where there's no gas stations open, you know, you're going to be struggling. It's going to be a survival mode. But the main thing, if you got any elderly, anybody with medical issues, try to find a family member out of town and get to them and just bear with it and, you know, stay with them.
So parish government is up and operating. What's going on? We see the crews working. It's a Herculean task.
Well, they're in a million different directions. You know, the main thing that I found out this morning, we got water back. Water is the main essential thing that we need to survive. Second is communication. We have our communication going. Third is going to be electricity, which, I mean, we're talking weeks, you know, weeks.
Now, you say communications. How good is cellular now? Because for a while, AT&T customers had none.
AT&T is still, it's a hit and miss, you know. If you got Verizon, you'll get communication, but they're still struggling. And it's getting better. Every day it's getting better.
You have to wonder, with hurricane force winds all over the parish, how could these cellular towers not have been damaged?
It was inevitable, you know. I mean, and like I said, when you got trees, 100-foot trees laying over, you know, towers were laid over. You know, I'm thankful that we do have Verizon to get even if it's hit and miss right now.
Well, it certainly is, and it's good that in Tangipahoa we have. You know, I can't help it, Joey. This is going to sound Pollyannish, but when you look at the reports from St. John Parish, Lafourche, Terrebonne, I don't want anybody to think I'm minimizing what we've had here, but we have a tremendous amount to be thankful for.
We're very thankful. I'm going to tell you, the further south you go, the more devastating it is. It's, you know, I called it catastrophic here, but then when you look at south, it's just leveled. I mean, it's just sad. I mean, you know, we all got to thank God right now that we're alive. If nobody's injured, that's your blessing you can have, you know.
What else do you want to share with us?
Well, I rode around yesterday in my district, and I saw some stuff that's a little disturbing. People need to realize they have generators in garages with the doors partially down. They got to put their generators out. They can't leave them in a garage in any kind of form. Under the eaves, they can't do that either. The fumes will build up and wind up in the house and get them carbon monoxide. The main thing is, don't get on the road if you don't have to. Don't burn your fuel, because you got to go. Right now, people are going to Macomb, Brookhaven, Jackson, Baton Rouge to get fuel. So if you can just hang in there, just bear with it. I know it's hot, but, you know, just be there for your family and stay, you know, stay safe.
And again, you can't live off a generator forever, especially when we're hearing it'll take a while before gasoline is normal again. The refineries themselves are shut down.
You're right. Yeah, we're trying to get gas now, and the only refineries are shut down. So we're struggling with it now. I just recommend everybody just bear with it, sit tight. Like I say, if you can stay there where you're at and survive, fine. But if not, find some means of going somewhere where you can be safe and have electricity.